हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द रेसिडेंटल स्टेटस ऑफ इंडिविजुअल। नाउ द क्वेश्चन मे अराइज इन योर माइंड दैट व्हाई देयर इज अ नीड टू डिटरमाइन द रेसिडेंटल स्टेटस। द आंसर इज दैट इन ऑर्डर टू डिटरमाइन द इंसिडेंस ऑफ अ टैक्स ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर इनकम, द डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ अ रेसिडेंटल स्टेटस इज नेसेसरी। इफ एन इंडिविजुअल इज अ रेसिडेंट, then whole over world's income may be a taxable in his hand. However, if the assessee is a non-resident, then only the Indian income may be a taxable. So now we will move on to the section 6 clause 1 of the Income Tax Act 1961. So as per section 6 clause 1, an individual is said to be a resident in India during the relevant previous year if he satisfy any one of the following condition. So here only one of the following condition needs to be satisfied. So there is no requirement that all the conditions should be satisfied. So what are that following condition? The condition number one is that he has been in India for 182 days or more during the previous year. So if an individual is in India for 182 days or more during the previous year, then he is considered as a resident in India. However, if any individual doesn't satisfy the criteria of 182 days or more, then what to do? Then we will go on the second basic condition. So what is the second basic condition? The second basic condition says that he has been in India for at least 60 days during the relevant previous year and 365 days or more during the 4 immediately preceding the relevant previous year. So here the joint criteria need to be fulfilled. That is, he shall be in India for 60 days or more during the relevant previous year plus 365 days or more during the 4 immediately preceding the previous year. So if an individual doesn't satisfy any one of the above basic condition, then he will be considered as a non-resident. If individual satisfy any one of the above basic condition, then he will be considered as a resident. Now, for the purpose of a stay in India, whether date of departure or a date of arrival is considered as a stay in India, the answer to that question is that both date of arrival as well as the date of departure are considered to be in India. Now, if you look into the basic condition, you will find that the wording that he has been in India. So what is the meaning of India? So the word India include the stay in a territorial waters of India. So India include the territorial water of India. So what is the meaning of territorial water? So territorial water means 12 nautical miles into the sea from the Indian coastline. So if a person is within the territorial waters of India, then such period of stay will be considered as in India for the purpose of determination of a residential status. Look into your study material. Even the stay in a ship or a boat in a territorial water of India would be the sufficient ground to make an individual as a resident in India. Now the question may arise whether a stay in India in order to satisfy the basic condition shall be in a continuous or a not. So again check your basic condition. He has been in India for a particular day. In both the condition, it will be a no requirement that the stay shall be in a continuous way. That means if Mr. X come to the India on 1st July 2020 and he returned to the Australia on 1st October 2020, that means he will be in India from 1st July to 1st October. Now he will again come to the India on 1st November and he will be in India till 28th February 2021. Then both the period from 1st July to 1st October and from 1st November to 28th February will be considered together in order to determine his residential status. So there is no requirement that the stay in India should be in a continuous way. Now another question may arise, whether the stay shall be at a usual place of a resident or at a usual place of a business premises or at any other place in India. So again, check the basic condition that he has been in India. There is nothing written in section 6 clause 1 that the stay shall be at a usual place of a resident or a usual place of a business premises at extra. So it is sufficient that he will be in India at any place, and you fulfill any one of the basic conditions given in a section 6 clause 1. Now the next is whether the place of a birth, domicile or citizenship is considered for the purpose of a residential status. The answer is, in order to determine the residential status as per the Income Tax Act 1961, there is nothing to do with the place of birth, domicile or a citizenship. Therefore, considering this, an individual may be resident in India along with another country. That means he may be resident in more than one country or a taxable territory. Now, there are certain exceptions. If you are falling under this exception, then you need to follow only first basic condition. You need not follow the second basic condition. So if you are coming under this exception, then you have to check only first basic condition. That is, he has been in India for 182 days or more during the relevant previous year. If he doesn't satisfy this condition and you are coming under the exceptional list, then he is considered as a non-resident. Then what are such exceptions? So the exceptions are as under: a person being an Indian citizen leaves India for the purpose of employment outside India, or a person being an Indian citizen leaves India as a member of crew. So if any person being an Indian citizen leaves India for the purpose of employment outside India or as a member of crew, then we will consider for the purpose of residential status only first basic condition, that is, he has been in India for 182 days or more during the relevant previous year. Here we will not consider the second basic condition. Now another exception is that if a person of an Indian citizen or an Indian origin comes to the India for the purpose of a visit, and his total income excluding foreign source of income does not exceed 15 lakh. That is, his Indian income is up to 50 lakh. So I am again revising that: person of an Indian origin or an Indian citizen comes to India for the purpose of visit, and his total Indian income, that is excluding foreign source of income, does not exceed 15 lakh, then here we will consider only the first basic condition for the purpose of a residential status. We will not check out the second basic condition. So under this exceptional criteria, we will check out only first basic condition, that he has been in India for 182 days or more. If he doesn't satisfy this condition, then it will be considered as a non-resident. Now, if a person of an Indian citizen or an Indian origin who comes to India for the purpose of a visit, and his total Indian income excluding foreign source of income exceed 15 lakh rupees, then his residential status will be determined as under: he will be in India for 182 days or more. That is your first basic condition. And the second basic condition, that he has been in India for 120 days or more during the relevant previous year and 365 days or more during the immediately for preceding the previous year. So here the 60 days in your second basic condition shall be replaced by 120 days. There is nothing change any of the other condition. So if a person of an Indian origin or an Indian citizen comes to India for the purpose of visit and his Indian income exceed 15 lakh, then here the second basic condition will be replaced from 60 days to 120 days. Now, what is the meaning of an Indian income? So, Indian income means the income which accrue or arise in India. The income which accrue or arise outside India will not be considered as an Indian income. However, if any business or profession set up outside India, but such profession or a business is controlled from India, then income from such business or profession will be considered as an Indian income. So I hope you will understand this.